Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys phase and how it works with noise reduction. So here we have a 1K tone. I'm sure you guys have heard this a million times. So that's a 1000 Hertz frequency. And how I got that in this system was over here in the Fairlight, I went to test tone settings up here, and then I just chose 1K tone. And that's our internal signal generator. And then I went over to my track one input and opened input. And from source, I chose system generator. And then you can see it says OSC for oscilloscope. And I patched that over to track one. So now if I hit record, since our input monitor is on, you'll get the 1K tone. That recorded. And here's what I wanted to show you. On this 1K tone, you have this gray line right here, and that's your zero crossing. So every frequency, every sound has a positive and a negative. So you could see as this goes above the line and then rounds down below the line and then back. And that's what your signal generator does. So I essentially duplicated this channel over to track two. Now we can reverse the phase, which is essentially taking the peak here and making the second track negative when the first track is positive. And that's going to look something like this. If we go down to my third track here, you can see while this one's peaking, this one has a negative zero crossing. So I'll show you that in a second, but I want to show you how you can do this in software. Now, if we have phase reverse off, you're going to get a doubling of loudness. So right now we have two tracks. Once we duplicate it, it gets double the volume. So here's track one. And if we solo track two, it's even louder. I did pull down my bus, so it's not blowing our ears out. So now we have two tracks playing back at the same time in phase. Now, if we go over to our track two, click on input and go to path settings, we have some controls for track two. And right here where trim is, we have this circle with a line through it, and that's our phase reverse button. So what that does is tell the track, I want the phase reversed before you hit the speakers. So this is like the software, and you used to do this with mixing boards too. So if you had, for example, two microphones, one's a further distance away, when those waveforms are traveling, one would hit the mic at a different time. So if they're out of time, you could phase reverse them or align them for phase. So this is the software way of doing it. And now if we keep this exactly how it was, watch what happens when I switch this phase on and off. Complete silence. And that's because it's the single frequency. So if we go on and off, literally the phase is canceling it out. So if you take the identical frequency and invert it, it cancels the phase out. Now I'm gonna take track one out of solo. We have track two in solo still, so you'll be able to hear this. Let's make sure the phase is off. So now this is default. Now I wanna show you what it does if we did it in real time with track three here. So track three, I just duplicated and shifted it to get it to line up where the peak and the negative, and this helps visually as well. So now these both are on. Let's solo track three as well. So when it hits down here where this track starts, you'll hear it cancel out now. So I'll go back to the home position here and we'll play. We got a little bit of volume because it's not 100% precisely out of phase. So if we zoom in, you can see we're a little bit off still. So if we're looking at track two's peak and track three, it could maybe come just a hair. Let's see how that does. There we go. So I thought that was pretty cool. I learned that in audio school with a 1K tone. Our teacher turned it up, played it, and phase inverted it, and it was like, whoa. So that's pretty much how noise reduction works. When you have a section where the noise is being sampled, the noise reduction plugin pretty much grabs that frequency sample and inverts the phase on it, and it cancels it out. Kind of a neat phenomenon. Now, when you have more complex sources, you'll get into some issues, some phasing where it'll sound hollow, it'll sound weird, things like that. But this is how that actually works. And I thought maybe you guys would like to see a visual demonstration of how phase reduction and phase reversal works. All right, so that's it for this video. just a little demo on a 1K tone. Hope that helps. Leave a comment if you got a video idea you want me to tackle, and I will jump on it. Subscribe if you haven't, if you like my content. Really helps me out. And I'll see you guys on the next video.